Okay, so let me show you how to create a survey. It's very easy. Here I've logged in and you are logged in too, probably to Survey123. I'm in the computer environment, so through a browser. And I only have one survey here. It's the RCS application review and it was shared with me. It's not created by me. It's created by LMF24 Calvin. So you probably see nothing here. To create a new survey, you simply click here on Create New Survey. Right, and now we have two options. We could use the web designer, which is what we're using here in the browser, or we could download the Survey123 Connect desktop application and install that on our computer. You could also use your phone to create these surveys. I don't recommend it just because it's a little difficult on small screens. So let's get started. Okay, now we'll name our survey and then add some tags and provide a short summary. And now I'll click on Create. Okay, so now my blank survey of tree health survey is here, and now we need to populate it with questions for the data collection process. On the right, you can see we have a whole bunch of options available to us to create different kinds of questions and data collection ideas for instrumentation and the field work. And so we can limit and build the parameters and constraints for the data collection process and really design the whole thing here before we deploy the actual survey. So let's do that together. The first thing I'd like to do is just simply choose the location. So we'll choose GeoPoint, and now we're going to provide for the end user here who has this survey the details related to that. So on the right you have kind of the parameters related to the question, and then on the left is the view that you would see in the survey itself. And so in this case I'm just going to set the location of your tree. And so, we could add in a hint here. I don't think I need to. It's pretty self-explanatory. And so instead of, clicking on this set location, I'm going to ask the device to open the question immediately. And we're going to require this, okay? And so here then, since it's just a requirement, we're going to allow you to use this little find me tool here on the screen to tap on it to find you if you can't be found wherever you are. And so now that I've created this question, I want to save it. So I'm going to save. And now that it's saved successfully, I'm going to move on to the next question in my survey by just clicking add. Okay, so here I'm going to add a multiple choice option. So really for multiple choice, we have this one, this multiple choice, and the drop down. Multiple choice shows you all of the different options on the screen, whereas drop down has a drop down menu of all possibilities. So this is a little more efficient in terms of screen usage. And so I'm going to create for this question a drop down. In this case, let's evaluate where you are for this data collection process. So what does your survey area look like? And here we'll add a hint so that we direct the data collector with a little more information. Choose one of the options below that best describes your area. Now let's populate with all the different choices. Here I'm going to add in after street, garden, school, some more options by clicking the plus here. It drops down more possibilities, so it's just park. Open field, forest edge, and let's go with the full forest. Inside, forested edge. No, area. Yeah. And now let's just assuming that maybe you're not in any of these, or the data collector isn't in any of these, and so we'll choose to allow other, so there'll be an other field where they could actually type in the details. And so on this question, we'll also make it required. And now, since we've completed all of those parameters, we're going to save. And now let's add in our next one. In this case, I'm going to choose a number. Let's choose a number. And so I click on number. And now we're going to collect some sort of numerical information from our end user. So let's measure the circumference at the diameter of breast height. Okay, and so we'll give the label . So we're going to measure the circumference of the tree at your chest height to the nearest quarter inch. I'm assuming that your tape measures are inches and you don't really have access to a bendable tape measure instruments out in the field that are in metric. And so we'll just do inches for our lab in this example. But let's add a hint to describe a little bit more what that looks like. So typically called DBH, diameter breast height, is determined based on the circumference at about 4 feet from the ground all the way up the tree trunk. So we'll get the circumference and then we'll have to do some calculation to actually get the diameter of the tree trunk itself. Let's make this a required question. And in this case, we don't want it to be an integer. We want it to be a decimal place. So we've got a quarter of an inch on the closest to that. And so we don't want to check this. And we don't have any requirement for minimum and maximum value. I'll go ahead and save now that we've completed that question. All right. Now let's do another multiple. No, let's do another number. Okay, so here we're going to get a percentage. So let's think about tree canopy. And now let's tell the user a hint. So what percentage of the sky can you see through the canopy when standing at the base of the tree? And so the idea is that if you can see 100% of the sky, you probably have a very dead tree. Whereas, you know, maybe only seeing 5% of the sky, you have a very strong, healthy tree canopy. So the lower the number, the more healthy the tree canopy is for our survey. Of course, this varies upon the kind of tree that you're looking at, and we're not going to collect species of tree because of the nature of this lab and what it would require for us to have that knowledge. There's no prerequisite to this course, and so we won't ask that, but we can at least ask this one. So we'll ask this as a required question. In this case, we do want to make an integer. We're going to say that, you know, we have to have a whole number there, so 75 or 25 or 50 or whatever you determine is what the value will be, but no decimal places. And now I'll save. Okay, let's add our last question here, and that is about the kind of life of the tree. And let's choose a multiple choice so you see an example of that. So I'll click on multiple choice. And now add a little bit more detail in the hint. Is a tree alive or dead? Either standing or leaning. That's okay. So dead trees could be standing or leaning. But if they're laying on the ground, don't include them in your survey. So here we're just really choosing two options, alive or dead. And then for the third choice, we don't need it, so let's remove it. And we don't want to allow an other in this. We just want to have living or dead. And we could change the appearance, of course, and we're going to make sure that this is a required question. And now we'll save it. Okay, so here's our survey. We have five parts to our survey. And maybe you want to rearrange things too. So here, maybe tree status life would be better to ask before the health of the tree canopy. So let's drag this right up here. And now we've moved it above that so that the tree canopy a question is the last question that we ask. And that's nice because we've separated a numerical with a multiple choice with another numerical. So I think that'll be a nicer kind of arrangement. Now I'm going to save again so that we save this rearrangement. And now that I'm done, I want to publish my survey and make it available to folks. So if I click on publish, then it actually leads me through kind of this questionnaire and check about whether or not I want to publish the survey. So here, I want to go ahead and choose to publish. Okay, now my tree health survey has been published, and now I can make it accessible to other people. You can see at the top here I have a share option now that it's enabled, and I'm going to click OK. And when I click on the share option, you can see a survey is the link here, or I can go in and share this survey directly with individuals that I want to collaborate with. So if I click on collaborate, and this is where I can add in the different folks that I want to be involved in this survey. So when you create your own survey, you won't need to include others, but you could for the lab. So that gives you an overview of how you create a survey in Survey123 and then make it accessible, publishing it so that you can actually download it in Survey123 on your smartphone and begin to collect data.